Simple History. Today, we're going to be learning about the Armenian Genocide and the tragedy that occurred during this time period. So without further ado, let's get started. The year is 1914. July. Germany has just declared war against Russia and France, actively starting what people would later call the Great War, or probably known as World War I. The war would mostly include Britain, Germany, France, Russia, the Ottoman Empire, Bulgaria, Italy, Austria-Hungary, and later the United States and Japan. During this period of time between 1914 and 1918, a great tragedy would occur in the Ottoman Empire that would for the most part go unnoticed because all the other countries were too busy focusing on the ongoing war. The sides of the war were split between the Central Powers and the Allies. The Ottomans were on the side of the Central Powers, better known as Germany's side. The Ottomans throughout the war weren't the best when it came to battles. In fact, they were mostly known for losing many battles and only winning a handful. This gave the people of the empire a lot of rage and anger. They felt the need to blame someone or something for their countless losses, and sadly, they were able to find one. The Ottoman Empire was a multinational country, meaning there were multiple nationalities within the country. A lot of the nationalities that lived in the country revolved around similar religions or the same religion. The biggest religion that was practiced by almost everyone in the country was Islam. Now, this fact made it so that Christianity was the minority religion in this country, and it was looked down upon. This was the religion of the Armenians. The Armenians were a population of people that lived in the Caucasus Mountains region of central southern Europe. During World War I, they were known for supporting the Allies of the war. This made everyone else in the country very angry, because everyone else was very nationalistic about their country, while the Armenians could honestly care less. So because of these factors, the majority of the Turkish/Ottoman Empire blamed the Armenians for their empire's shortcomings. At some point, the anger and distaste towards the Armenians boiled over, having one of the worst possible outcomes ever. In 1915, the Ottoman Empire passed the Turkic Law. This law would basically give permission to deport Armenians. This, however, didn't happen accordingly, and instead resulted in anywhere from 800,000 to 1.8 million Armenians' deaths. Turkish soldiers in July were ordered to go to Armenian homes and villages like Aldagin, Megrakom, and Kashik to deport them, but instead tortured and killed the heads of these villages. The rest of the men, women, and children were beaten or shot if they didn't comply with the soldiers' commands. They were forced to give up all their prized possessions such as jewelry, money, and really anything of value. Huge burn pits were made out of sheds that women and children would be disposed of. Mind you, women and children would still be alive. The rest of the people that survived these attacks would be ordered to walk 620 miles in the summer heat to what is now known as Syria, to be killed. This was called the Death March. Many men, women, and children died during this march, but those who survived when they arrived in Syria had to dig large holes so the soldiers could shoot them. Basically, they dug their own graves before being killed, and others, if they were strong enough, were transported to concentration camps at the edge of the Turkey and Syrian border. Those who were able to make it through the deportation were approximately 300,000 citizens. The people that survived were mostly people who had gone through the re-education that some were offered. This re-education basically consisted of learning Islam and becoming fully Islamic. This tragedy has gone very under the radar and is now very rarely brought up, if at all. And although this tragedy took place in the Ottoman Empire, the Central Powers knew about what was happening because soldiers were stationed out in the empire from the other countries. These soldiers would later go back to their country and tell the stories of the genocide to their fellow comrades. This event would give the later leader of Germany, Adolf Hitler, an example that nobody truly cared about the wiping out of minority groups. He is quoted saying, "Our strength consists in our speed and in our brutality. Genghis Khan led millions of women and children to slaughter with premeditation and a happy heart. History sees in him solely the founder of a state. It's a matter of indifference to me what a weak Western European civilization will say about me. I have issued the command, and I'll have anybody who utters but one word of criticism executed by a firing squad, that our war aim does not consist in reaching certain lines, but in the physical destruction of the enemy. Accordingly, I've placed my death head formation in readiness, for the present only in the east,
with orders to them to send death mercilessly and without compassion, men, women, and children of Polish derivation and language. Only thus shall we gain the living space which we need. Who, after all, speaks today of the annihilation of the Armenians? This was told to, and pardon if I say this wrong, Russian Marshal Hermann Göring and the commanding generals of Oberschwaberg, August 22, 1939, in preparation for the impending invasion of Poland. Again, sorry if I butchered that. A question about the tragedy later on. The Turkish president and government claim that though a lot of Armenians died during the deportation, they do not consider it a genocide, because genocide is defined as the deliberate killing of a large number of people from a particular nation or ethnic group with the aim of destroying that nation or group. But they didn't tell the soldiers to kill the Armenians outright. Today, the Armenian population mostly lives in Armenia, a little east to present-day Turkey. I hope you guys were able to learn a little bit more about the history of the Armenian and the Great Armenian Tragedy that took place from 1915 to 1916. I'm sorry this video took so long to do. I've been caught up doing a lot of other stuff recently, but I'll be making more videos very soon. Thanks for watching, and make sure to like and subscribe, and let me know what you think about the Armenian Tragedy.